studio today is Kim Frickleton.
Today we lift off with news of the biggest air show due to be airborne next week. Pieces in the air and thousands of kids are going to sing for it tomorrow. Mr. and Miss Johannesburg Youth were crowned last week. Roundabout brings you the winners. And staying with the youth, we show you what the Youth Festival is all about. Plus, the big news is that KTV is getting a new image and Roundabout has a sneak peek just for you. Good morning, I am Kim Frickleton. Next week, the sky over Lanseria Airport is going to be filled with anything and, believe me, everything that can fly with or without wings. Because Africa's greatest air show is about to take off. The day is going to start at dawn with a mass hot air balloon launch. If you get there early, you stand a very good chance of winning a high ride in a hot air balloon. Later on in the day, you can catch a feat never seen at Lanseria, a Mirage F5 fighter jet in action, and air-to-air refueling from a Boeing tanker. There is also going to be a mass 130-man parachute drop from a Hercules plane, and then you'll be able to see old and new biplanes, hang gliders, choppers, stunt planes, and absolutely anything that flies. The special thing about the air show is you're going to be able to get up really close to many of the planes and see what the insides are like. Another bonus is that there are going to be prizes up for grabs all day, including, listen to this, free tickets to a trip in the sound barrier breaking Concorde. In fact, next week on Roundabout, we'll be giving away free tickets to the air show. That's Africa's greatest air show next Saturday at Lanseria Airport between Johannesburg and Pretoria. Entrance fee is 10 rand for adults and only 2 rand for kids. Gates open early and the show starts at 10 a.m. Another event happening near the Lanseria Airport is the Listen to the Children's Family Fair. Tomorrow, over 5,000 kids are getting together to sing songs of peace and have a fun time. PJ Powell will be singing with those kids to the music of Tranquility and others. After that, the rest of the day is going to be filled with live entertainment and activity. If you already have plans tomorrow, then cancel them and make your way to the Gary Player Farm near the Lanseria Airport between Johannesburg and Pretoria. The fun starts at about 11 a.m. and is expected to go on until well into the late afternoon. Entrance fee is 10 rand and for adults and only 5 rand for kids. This week saw the launch of the first annual Johannesburg International Youth Festival. So far, thousands of eager kids have experienced the festival during school weeks, and Wayne Copping was one of them. He went to find out what the school week is like and what we can still expect to see.
Be missed. This is Wayne Copping for KTV Roundabout.
That festival is certainly something special, so make sure you don't miss it. Don't forget tomorrow there's going to be a huge concert featuring some of South Africa's top bands, including Black Noise. That is Super Sunday and it starts at about 11 o'clock. Then from Monday to next Saturday, the Johannesburg Youth Festival is going to open its doors to the public to take part in all the excitement. The festival village is situated on the grounds of the National School of the Arts on Mele and Empire Roads, Bramfontein, so do not miss it. Last Sunday night, the grandest couple in Johannesburg were crowned at the prestigious Mr. and Miss Johannesburg Youth Contest. Wayne was there to bring you the lowdown.
Caesar's Palace in Bramfontein, Johannesburg is the venue for the 1993 Mr. and Miss Johannesburg Youth Competition. The couple that wins tonight are not only going to be chosen on their good looks and the way they present themselves.
And then, when the couple walk down the ramp, the audience...
Here are the winners. Do you expect to become a winner?
No, not at all.
Do you do this kind of thing often?
No, not very often. First time.
How about you?
First time as well. I've never entered something like this before, and I really didn't think I'd win.
Big question over here. What are you guys going to be walking home with? What are your prizes?
Well, there are many things that we've been given. I'd say a book, flowers, a modeling contract with the agency, and writing pad, a number of other things. I haven't had a look to see what is it there is.
All these prizes have been generous. There's even a gym contract and a whole lot of other things in there. Now, I've got a question to ask.
Well done there, Ross and Tamara, and all the best to you. Now, you may have heard many rumors that KTV is changing its look and that there is lots of exciting things going to happen. Well, in that case, the rumors are true. Yes, KTV is getting an attitude, and all that means is that we are going to have a lot more fun. Take a look at this.
Yeah. We got lots to do, we got plenty to say, and what we got to say is going to make you stay. So come on, all you people, gather on this TV thing, this KTV thing is going to make you sing. Check out this attitude, you're fucking hip and cool. You see you, where the kids, where the attitude is everyone.
totally amazing. Sorry guys, can't show you anymore. The next time you tune into the club next Saturday, you'll be able to catch the new look KTV. And that rounds it off for today. If you too would like to get your event or news onto KTV Roundabout, then all you have to do is send us all the info to this address.
KTV Roundabout, PO Box 6444, Westgate 1734. Or call us on the Roundabout hotline on Johannesburg dialing code 011-47-5544. Weekdays and mornings only.
Next Saturday, we bring you a special on what is known as Formula M motor racing. And tomorrow in Roundabout, we have news of plays, movies and events. Well, after Roundabout today, we have the Jetsons. Until then, good morning.
That kids can use.
Hey, Jimmy.
Good morning, Wayne. I tell you, this has really been a busy news week, both locally and, of course, internationally.
Yeah, it sure has, Kim. And I know now that it's time for some good news for all of you out there, and that's exactly what Roundabout has for you. And these are all the headlines. Today, we have news of the Special Olympics happening soon. We meet the friendliest giant in town, and together with Standard Bank Auto Club, we have hints on how to make you mega bucks. Plus, Roundabout gets into the swing of the anti-drug thing.
Great, but before we get our teeth into the next item, let's take a quick look outside the Roundabout studio to take a fix on what the weather is like. At last, summer is here. This morning, the mercury is sitting at a very comfortable 23 degrees Celsius, and we hope it's going to get even hotter. We predict it's going to be fine and sunny here today, so if you're planning any outdoor activity, it's a green light for you, and have fun.
Special Olympics, isn't that a sporting event that's specifically for mentally or physically disabled people?
That's right. And it seems that the Olympics are right upon us. A group of about six first-year physical education students at Wits University have organized a Special Olympics gymnastics competition. Yesterday was the preliminaries, and today you'll be able to check out the competition. The venue is the Old Mutual Sports Hall, East Campus of Wits University in Johannesburg. The competition will be starting in about an hour and will run until about 3 this afternoon. You're invited to attend and show your support.
Now, that's for gymnastics, but don't worry guys, if you're into soccer, then the Soccer Special Olympics are happening next week, and it's going to be great. Over 250 players will be competing in this event, and it's going to be working in a round-robin system. The venue is Marks Park, Judith Road in Emerentia, that's in Johannesburg. The dates are the 13th and the 14th of October, and the times are between 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. If you want any more information, hey, why don't you call Mandy on 011-616-1205.
And from Special Olympics, it's over to the serious subject of drugs. SANCA, which is the South African Council of Alcoholism and Drug Dependence, are holding an anti-drug Mardi Gras next weekend to fight against drug abuse as well as bring a message of peace and goodwill to our country.
Now, Plantation Road in Melville, Johannesburg is going to be closed off to allow for flea market stalls and action areas as well as a volleyball area. Now listen to this, there's a marathon 36-hour volleyball tournament that's going to be taking place. We recommend that you get on down to the Mardi Gras next weekend and join in the fun. Here are all the details once again.
That's the anti-drug Mardi Gras happening next weekend, the 16th and 17th of October. The venue is Plantation Road, Melville, Johannesburg, and everyone is invited. For more info, call Leslie Ann at SANCO on Johannesburg 011-836-5942.
And still on the subject of drugs, did you know that the A-plus school in Midrand are the first in the country to become drug-free marshals?
And that means that there are a group of kids that are fighting against drugs. What they have to do is write an essay on how they can create a drug-free community. And then they get sworn in by the South African police at a ceremony, and they pledge to lead a drug-free life and help others to do so too.
After that, they get a copy of the pledge and then the special drug badges to take home. Now, if you too want to become a drug-free marshal, if you want a bit more info, then you can write to Kimmy, the one thing about about Standard Bank is that they're really in tune with what we want.
That's right, and let's not kid, we want money, and you can win lots of it by entering a great competition. Take a look at this.
This is Tammy. Soon she's going to turn to page 109 of our October Mnet guide and discover...
Come up with a bright idea on how to make money and send your entry in to us by the October the 30th, 1993. The entry form can be found in this month's Mnet Guide on page 109. This is a great competition, so you'd better get those grey cells working and make some money.
Now, African tales have held the imagination of people of all ages, and now you too can go and enjoy an excellent African tale. Now, this show is a show with a bit of a difference.
You said it, Wayne, because the stars of the show are puppets.
That's right. Now, if you would like to see the show and if you would like to carry on and go and see the show, then why don't you get on down to the Johannesburg Civic Theatre. There'll be morning and afternoon shows and the...
And that wraps up Roundabout for today. As you know, you can also get your event mentioned on Roundabout. It's easy. All you have to do is send your info and vision material to...
644 Westgate 1734. Or you can call us on our Roundabout hotline on Johannesburg 011-4755-44, and that's weekdays and mornings.
For the rest of the day.
Well, to be honest, Wayne, I'm not quite sure, but what I do know is we are going to have a mega rave until about 11 o'clock.
That's right, yeah, KTV sure has all the fun, and the fun is going to continue right here with the Jetsons. So from me, Kim Frickleton.
And me, Wayne Cumming. Good morning.
Good morning, Kim Frickleton.
News. This is Sunday Morning Roundabout. In the studio is Kim Frickleton and Wayne Gopping.
Hi, Wayne.
Hi there, Kim. And of course, a very good morning to all of you out there. It's that time of the day when we have news about kids, for kids, and some action.
That's right. We have the latest news on the world traveling teddy bear, and we meet a little girl with a big voice. You'll remember that not too long ago, we ran a story on KTV about a little teddy bear that travels the world.
Now, that is one lucky teddy bear.
Remember those milkshakes? If you don't remember, then this should refresh your memory.
Teddy Aloha is the luckiest teddy bear in the world. He was sent from Kau, the one of the islands of Hawaii, to travel the world, and so far he has been to many, many places like Russia, the Far East, Israel, Scandinavia, UK, the USA, and a couple of other places I've never even heard of. Well, Teddy Aloha landed in South Africa recently, and the Roundabout team, in conjunction with Lufthansa Airlines, took him to Cape Town to show him South Africa's mother city. When he arrived, the weather was not so great, but we managed to land at Tiefenmalen Airport, and this is where our story starts.
Well, what can I say? We've arrived safely in Cape Town, and here we are at the very famous Victoria and Alfred waterfront. And there's so much to do here, Teddy Aloha. What do you want to do in Cape Town? There's Table Mountain, Hart Bay, Sea Point. What? Excuse me a sec. Beg your pardon? You want a milkshake? You're in Cape Town and you want a... He said, not just any milkshake. He wants a milkshake with extra berries and honey. Well, where are we going to find... Kim is going to know exactly where. Won't you, Kim? Where is she?
I know just the spot. Come with me.
Come on, guys.
Well, as you can see, the Dodge City Diner was our only hope of getting Teddy a great milkshake with extra berries and honey. We decided to try one ourselves, and I must say it wasn't bad, but the real test was to see whether Teddy would like it. So... yes, he does like it. That does it. He loves the berry milkshake at Dodge City Diner. So does Kim. And from there, we took a slow walk along the V&A waterfront to see all the different types of yachts and boats. Teddy said he'd never seen so many stunning boats and yachts in one place, and that he wanted us to put one of those yachts and boats into his little bag. He wanted to take it back home with him.
Well, Teddy Aloha, as you can see, that is the famous Table Mountain. And it's called Table Mountain because it's shaped like a tabletop.
Yeah, no kidding, Kim. Well, as you can see, there are plenty of clouds back there, and they form the famous table clock. Yeah. all those clouds up there really make it cold. In fact, too
freezing.
Cold. Yeah, very freezing. You could freeze all your fur up, so I don't think we want to take you up there. But we thought we'd show you Table Mountain from this angle anyway. And from that angle, and that angle, and that angle.
Pretty groovy stuff, eh?
And even, and even that angle. Oh, well, there you've seen Table Mountain, Teddy.
But now there's so many other places I want to go to. Ask him where he wants to go.
Where do you want to go to now, Teddy?
You
already had a milkshake. He wants to go to Heart Bay. Come on, guys. Kim, Teddy and I have lost our bearings, and we're not quite sure where we are.
Well, we are now on the other side of Table Mountain, and we're on a beautiful beach off South Bay.
Oh, of course. We said we were going there, weren't we?
Yes.
See that, Teddy? That is the beach. Let's go for a swim.
No, wait. There is no way you're going
for
me.
Gonna go
it
for
is
a
freezing
swim.
Cold. No, he is going to get sick. There's no way. I'll tell you what, though.
Right.
I'll take a picture of you two.
Okay.
And then it'll look like you're swimming.
Is this my good side? Is this my good side?
Yeah. You don't have a good side.
So I haven't got a good side.
Okay, ready?
One.
Smile. One, two, three. Click.
Right.
Excellent.
Really is beautiful, isn't it? In fact, all of this is making me a little bit hungry.
I'm starving.
What do you feel like? Some fish?
Fish and chips.
Fish and chips. Let me tell you that right here, the freshest fish are caught. The boat's over here, Teddy, and all of you out there. The fish is over here. They go out early, early in the morning, and they catch all the fish, and they take them right there to the fish market, and you have the freshest fish in the South Africa.
And I feel like some right now.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Teddy, go! Now let me tell you that seafood is a Heart Bay speciality, and you can have anything your heart may desire. For once, Teddy was not being difficult, and all he asked for was plain old fish and chips. Now we were so busy drinking our milkshakes and eating our fish and having so much fun that we totally lost our bearing on the time. And then we packed up all our stuff, it was all hands back into the bus to get us back to the airport. I've had a great time. In fact, we've all had a very, very good time. Well, we're on our way back to Johannesburg, and tell me, Teddy, where are you going to now?
Well, I'll tell you. He's meeting up with some friends in Varick Airlines, and next week this time he'll be in Rio. Can you believe it?
I don't believe it.
He can go to the Rio Festival and do some dancing.
Well, he won't have as much fun as we have had, thanks to Lufthansa, and we're going business class, isn't that right?
And remember to look out for Teddy Aloha in your neighborhood, because he's traveling fast.
Yeah, so bon voyage to you.
Yeah.
This is me, Wayne Copping.
Me, Kim Frickleton.
And little Teddy Aloha for KTV Roundabout.
Cheers.
Now, when we last spoke to you about Teddy Aloha, we told you he was lost. Well, he's found, and we have the latest for you. We received a letter from Scott Ross Kelly, Teddy's owner, and he says that Teddy returned to Kauai safe and sound on the 31st of August, 1993.
And when Teddy got home, Scott had planned a huge fanfare for him, and Scott is going to write a book about the bear's travels. And as soon as it's published, we will let you know. And from teddy bears going places to a little girl that is definitely going places, 12-year-old Leanne Weideman came into the club to show us her stuff.
Well, it seems that that's it for Sunday morning, right about this Sunday morning.
You said it, Wayne, and don't forget to join us next Saturday when we have more excellent news that kids can use. Up now is Bumpity Boo. Until then, cheers.
Bye.
Okay, girls, listen, we finished at 11. We can be out of here by 11:05. Get down to Woolworths.
Let's go shopping.
We'll get a good day
and
shopping.
Then we'll do lunch.
We can do lunch. And remember, you can get the clothes from $29.99 up until $69.99. And they're, of course, from
Woolworths. And thanks, Leanne, for coming to join us today.
Thanks, Gina and Kim. And that's it for this week.
And boys, I hope you are paying attention. And girls, you don't trust your boys with their Christmas presents. Don't hassle, because you can get down to your nearest Woolworths store and shop, shop, shop like us. And Kimmy, isn't there something special for next week?
Yes, we have a surprise for you. We have Nadia Champion coming. Now, she's a young designer, but when I say young, she's young. She's only 19 and she has an exclusive range.
Jealous.
Coming into the diner to show us exclusively. So until then, stay cool and
shop until you drop.
What was that Kim said? Shop until you drop? What? I don't know what I know. I'm just a guy. Well, I hope that Kim can pull herself away from Kids Clubber long enough to come to us for KTV Roundabout at about 9:10, because we've got another most excellent edition. Today, we take a look behind the scenes at the KTV Wild Coast weekend, and we have hints on how to jump on the beach.
When you hear the signal, it will be 9:10 exactly. KTV Roundabout is brought to you by the Standard Bank Auto Club. In the studio today is Kim Frickleton and Wayne Copping.
Hi there.
Oh, hi there, Kim. And of course, a very good morning to each and every single one of you this morning on KTV Roundabout. Today, we're going to be taking a look at some weird and wonderful news that kids can use. Kim has all the headlines.
Roundabout goes wild today with our friends down at the Wild Coast. South Africa has been admitted to the World Union of Karate, and we have details of the event that will send some kids to the World Champs in Budapest. We have hints on how to jump on a bed and not get into trouble for it, and we take a look at the most fun you can have with rubber stamps.
Phew, what a lineup, isn't it? As usual, before we get stuck into the news, I think we should take a quick look outside the Roundabout studios in Randburg to get a fix on what the weather is like.
6 degrees Celsius around the Randburg area, and we hope it's going to get warmer. We predict cool weather today, so if you're planning any outdoor activity, then go ahead.
Now, if you guys happen to think that karate was just a hobby with a few kicks and chops, well then, think again. Since CASA, or the Karate Association of South Africa, was formed a little while ago, the rest of the world had better look out because South Africa is here.
Once all three of the existing karate associations got together to form CASA, they can represent South Africa at international competitions, namely the 1996 Olympic Games, and more imminent, the World Championships next month. Today is the National Karate Championships, and the tournament is particularly important because the teams that will compete in Budapest next month will be decided today.
Yeah, this is quite interesting. You know, the venue is Kibler Recreation Club in Kibler Park, and both boys and girls between 9 and 18 years old are going to be fighting their hearts out in the hope of fighting for South Africa.
Now, there's no escaping the fact that Christmas is nearly upon us. Excellent. So it's time for all those cards and gifts. Wouldn't it be great if you get something original?
Yeah, tell me about it. Well, Kimmy, now you can get your very own personalized and original cards. In fact, you can make them. Two of them may never even look the same. All you have to do is get creative with the all-new art rubber stamps.
And all you need is a multicolored stamp pad, one or two rubber stamps, paper or card, and embossing powder. It'll cost you around 50 rand, and voila, you can make around 300 cards.
Now, there are workshops happening all over the country to try and help people make the most of their art rubber.
And if you don't know what to do today, then we have just the thing for you. Welcome back. I think that almost every kid out there, myself included, at some stage or another has been shouted at for jumping on the bed.
Yeah, tell me about it. Me, every single day. In fact, yesterday. Anyway, now you guys can jump on a bed all you like and get away with it. If you happen to live in Barberton, in Eastern Transvaal, that is.
Yesterday at 2 o'clock, the pupils of Barberton Primary School began a 24-hour mattress jumping marathon. The venue is the Russell Store in Barberton, and there were 5 teams of 16 kids each. Each team member has to jump simultaneously for 15 minutes at a time, which makes a total of 7,200 minutes on 5 mattresses. If you are anywhere near Russell's in Barberton, then pop down there before 2 o'clock and support those exhausted jumpers.
Moving on, if you are in a bit of a quandary as to what you guys should be doing today, and if you happen to live near Bryanston in Johannesburg, then have I got news for you. You can go on helicopter rise, abseil, Bryandale Primary School.
Right here on KTV Roundabout. If you're going to send us news, info, or even art for that matter, please make sure you leave your name, address, and contact telephone number so we can get back to you.
Yeah, quite right. The other day, we happened to receive the cutest picture of a very wise roundabout owl. At least we think it's an owl. We don't know who the artist is, and we really love it, so we want you guys to tell us who it is. So, if it was you, or if you have any relevant information that would lead us to the phantom artist, then please could you send the info to us to this all-important address.
KTV Roundabout, P.O. Box.
No, it doesn't. We just got something on the line here from these Reuters kind of people. It says, oh dear, it says, Kimmy, please tell Wayne to stop jabbering so we can get on with the show. Candace is standing by with Wise and Wonders. This is from Delport Fun Skullcrack.
Well,
You heard them when we better get out of here. We'll see you tomorrow morning on Sunday Morning Roundabout.
Tell all you guys not to miss Casper and Friends on KTV from Monday to Friday, 3:30 until 4.
Casper and Friends brought to you on KTV by Total.
Don't miss it!
That kids can use. This is Sunday Morning Roundabout. Standing by in the studio is Kim Frickleton and Wayne Cupping. Good morning, Wayne.
Hi there, Kim, and of course, hi there to everyone. We've got quite a fun edition of KTV Roundabout lined up for you. This is Kim with the headlines.
If you have ever been in trouble in South Africa's waters, you'll want to be rescued by the heroes we'll meet today. We have news of a great flea market fun happening today, and we go down to Cape Town to check out Pinocchio.
Once upon a time, there was an old man by the name of Geppetto. He made a little puppet out of wood, and this puppet somehow came to life. This is the story of Pinocchio, and if you want to see it come to life before your very eyes, then make sure you do not miss Hertzler Primary School show down in Cape Town.
For months, the cast of over 175 school kids have been working furiously to make this a feast for your eyes.
If there was ever a show for everyone in your family, including your dog Spot, this is it. Pinocchio is only running for 4 days, so you'd better book ASAP. Here are the details. Pinocchio runs from next Wednesday.
You see, if our life grows, you
definitely
see.
Not growing. South African waters are fun places to spend a little time in, but we all know that out there anything can happen. When you're in trouble, who are you going to call? Not Ghostbusters. You're going to call the NSRI. The National Sea Rescue Institute are based all over South Africa and are committed to keeping all of us safe in the water. To date, they have rescued thousands of people who without their help would have, well, let's just say they would not be around to tell the story. There are not many things as exciting as a high sea rescue, so fasten your seatbelt, the Roundabout team is about to take you on one.
Every single day, the men and women...
Gee, those guys are incredible, Wayne, real heroes.
Yeah, they really are. You must see these guys in action. It's incredible.
Sure.
But now for something completely different, as I say. I know I don't only speak for myself when I say there's a flea market with a special place in our hearts. Yep, it's the Balfour Park Flea Market. Today they're having their spring bonanza, which will go on all day. The fun includes taekwondo displays, an appearance by the real Barbie doll, a crazy Ollie the Clown show. There's also going to be singers, fire eaters, jumping castles, pony rides, fun fair, and not to mention stalls with hundreds of exciting things to buy.
If you have anything planned for today, I say cancel it and get on down.
Well, I'm just taking a look here and I'm taking a look there, and it seems that that's about it for this Sunday morning's Roundabout.
Yep, it sure is, and I hope that everybody realizes how easy it is to promote an event on Roundabout. All you have to do is send your info and visual material to this address. KTV Roundabout, PO Box 6444, Westgate.
Well, Kim, to wrap it up, after you.
No, I insist, after you.
No, I insist, after you.
Okay, be sure to join us next Saturday when we have more excellent news that kids can use. Up next now is...
Bumpity Boo.
Bye.
Edition where you can stay tuned for some rip-roaring adventure.
For sure, this is
a... And you can win incredible prizes in freebies, playback, and of course, the congrats line. The most important number in the world is 0800-122-345. So get those telephones.
And then we join the family that doesn't get along, the Adams family, right before
Good
we...
gross stuff, so I'm going to choose one lucky, or should I say unlucky contestant to play. So who wants to play? Let me see. Let's take you. Come on down. Hi there, what's your name? Lionel. Okay, quickly take off your shoes, throw them off, and we're going to put on these boots, the gum boots, so that you don't get all goo in your shoes. Yeah. All right, now what we're going to do is we're going to blindfold you. Have you seen how this works? Okay, we're going to blindfold you, so there is absolutely no peeping. And we are going to blindfold you so that your mother doesn't freak when you get home with all this yuck stuff all over you. All right, let me tie you. Okay, Lionel, are you ready to play? Come and stand over here.
brace yourself for the most disgusting stuff you have ever in your life seen. Yeah! Okay, Lionel, on the count of three. One, two, three. Sus! Come on, take something out.
Okay, it's so gross.
Okay, now, tell me what it is. What does it feel like?
Oh, sick.
Lionel, what does it feel like? It's something that you shoot with.